新年祝福里面绝对少不了许愿过得更健康。英国的伦敦大学研究显示，每天只要快走20分钟，在家里快走20分钟，或者进行简单的平衡和伸展，你可以帮助心脏跟整体健康。甜点也走健康路线，澳大利亚一家烘焙坊是以南瓜和菠菜研发出美味蛋糕，看的就觉得还不错吃。
缤纷可口的装饰还放上花瓣点缀，蛋糕甜点总让人光是动念想吃都有罪恶感。不过在澳洲这家烘焙坊，蛋糕的食材听起来就像一盘沙拉的清爽组合。
Spinach, turmeric, pumpkin, beetroot。
这是新南威尔斯州当地一间送餐慈善机构70周年的礼物。由于机构服务的大多是老人家，烘焙坊特地与学界合作研发出这款超健康蛋糕。由于食材和传统甜点差距太大，每种比例要抓得精准才能做出甜食的感觉。
The first version I did tasted like a curry.
谁能想到吃蛋糕也能有益健康？御用的食材甜菜根可以保护人体神经网络，橄榄油能降低罹患失智症的风险，蜂蜜具抗发炎作用，蓝莓可以增强血液中的含氧量。
There is molecules in food ingredients which do have powerful and strong effects in keeping us healthy.
进入新的一年，怎样吃才能吃得健康呢？美国新闻与世界报道文章指出，地中海饮食已经连续7年获得最佳饮食第一名。
The Mediterranean diet really is one of the very, very best, and the reason is because it's so clinically proven to have positive health outcomes.
地中海饮食包括几个要件，主要是吃天然食材、全谷物、新鲜水果、蔬菜和豆类。此外，使用特级初榨橄榄油，加入洛梨、坚果，也鼓励使用含丰富 omega-3 脂肪酸的鱼类。虽然禽肉和蛋白质摄取量比传统西方饮食少，但对加工食品说不就足以截长补短。
Lastly, we really limit things like dairy. So,can have a little bit of cheese on the Mediterranean diet, but it's really just kind of a dusting, just to add some flavor, but not the foundation of a meal. And it shouldn't really be consumed every day.
专业营养师建议，老话一句，均衡饮食，偏食、挑食都不好。如果真的要饮酒，适量喝点红酒就好。
No alcohol is better than any alcohol we have found to be true when it comes to health outcomes. But if you are going to drink, really stick to.That red wine.
一般人注意饮食养生，糖尿病患者更是要处处忌口。现在有穿戴型的监控设备，方便民众随时透过智慧手机查看身体的血糖、血酮和乳酸变化。
Knowing that there's type 2 diabetes in my family, knowing that there's dementia in my family, I don't want to have either of those things long term. So what can I do now to improve my health now?
外形轻巧，只要像这样贴在手臂上，设备费用为300英镑，约合台币18000元，还要支付每个月25到60英镑，约合台币1000到2400的服务费用。调查发现，目前在英国，这款产品正在受到非糖尿病族群的民众欢迎，估计用户数量超过10万人。
The way it works is you have the biosensor on your arm. It transmits your glucose levels in real time to your smartphone, and then you get small tips and insights as to.How you can make small changes to your everyday and create long-lasting habits so that you can feel better, have more energy, improved mood.
不过学者认为，别把监控血糖当成最新科技养生的方式。人体健康需要全面性的评估，只单凭几项数据是没有用的。
By overly focusing on one aspect of your metabolism, i.e. glucose, an individual might be neglecting all of the other aspects of their metabolism and health, for example, you know, blood pressure or cholesterol levels or weight.
想活出健康，就从脱离沙发马铃薯开始吧。英国伦敦大学研究显示，每天只要快走20分钟，在家里进行简单的平衡和伸展，就能帮助保持心脏和整体健康。
You get more benefit from replacing 10 minutes of sitting or 10 minutes of standing. And always we found that sitting or laying, so sedentary behaviors, were the worst for you. So things like watching TV, even sitting in a car, commuting, laying down on the sofa, scrolling on your phone, that type of thing.
世界卫生组织建议每周应该进行150分钟的中度到强度运动，增加心脏健康。专家建议尽可能减少每天坐着的时间，利用零星休息空档，快走或骑脚踏车都是不错的选择。
The simple exercises you can start to do to ensure that you maintain your physical fitness as you get older are things like squats and lunges for your lower body.Press-ups against a wall if you can't do them on the floor. Also think about the activities in your daily life.
别把运动想得太难，随时随地能站就别坐，乐活好动，拥有健康人生。 TVBS 新闻综合报道。